Hey, what's up, guys? Ram here again. Today we're going to learn how to pick a combination lock. This is a Brinks model. The method we're going to use is the shim method. I know there's 100 other videos online that shows us the exact thing, but I'm hoping my quality will be a little better because most of them don't have good cameras. And I hope I can explain that a little bit better. Start off by showing you how to do the shim, or make the shim. Just take a soda can, make a little notch in it. What you'll do is you cut the top off if you want.
Alright, once you have the top cut off, go ahead and cut down the sides. Make your little rectangle. So that if you end up with a blank, probably about this size. Yeah, you can go ahead and cut up, even the edges up, and curl them up. Make them a little bit more safe to work with, but a little closer. Alright, once you have your blank, go ahead, move in from the corners about, I say, a quarter of an inch. Cut up, both sides. Okay. Go ahead and move in at an angle. Cut out these little triangles. So at your left, we're in the M shape. About like that. I find that if you have a smaller, thinner centerpiece, it tends to work a lot better. Alright, after you have your M shape, what you want to do is you want to bend, fold the top down. About like that. Fold the tabs up and over. This creates a little handle for you to grab onto. So that you now have something like this. Alright, once you get to this point, just go ahead and you want to take your shackle on your lock and you can use it to form the curve in your shim. Since this is what you're going to be picking, this makes it a lot easier for it to go down into the hole like that. So, that's what your final shape needs to look like. Alright, first thing you do when you're ready to pick your lock is know which side the lock actually opens on. Mine opens here on the left side. And let me show it and show you. The piece down there is what you're actually shimming. When you curve it around, it pushes that piece out of the way and opens the lock. So go ahead and lock it. Alright, like I said, the actual piece that you're picking is on the hidden side here. But I find if you start on the outside and slide your shim down in there, it makes it a lot easier. Then all you have to do is grab your little tab that you made and turn the shim around to the inside, pushing down it. And as you do, just pull your lock, and that should open pretty easily. Right, just a quick note, the shims are only good for about one time. As you see, it kind of gets a little damaged as you do it. And the last thing you want to do is have any wrinkles or anything when you're trying to do this method, because it binds up inside and it won't turn as easy and it won't pick the way that you want it to. So make up a couple of these and you should be able to practice on it and get a lot better at it. All right, guys, I'll give you one more look at it. Like I said, just go ahead and start on the outside. Just shim. Slide it as far as you can down in there. And just grab the tabs. Spin it around. Put a little downward motion on it as you're doing so. And then just pull up. Sometimes it's a little hard and other times, but it always works if you do it right. Alright, guys. I hope you liked the video. If you enjoyed it, please leave me a comment. Tell me about it. If you have any questions, leave me a comment also below. I'm making a video on a regular basis. So if you could, just please subscribe to my channel. You'll see when they come out. If you have any requested videos, you can also leave that. I do my best to make them. And you can give me a thumbs up if you like it. And hope you enjoyed it. Thanks.